other. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, folks, here's the headlines up at DrudgeReport.com. And we'll put DrudgeReport.com up on screen. Heavily armed feds surround Nevada ranch. CNN. Here's the top story above that. County commissioner says Bundy ranch supporters better have funeral plans. Lawmaker cattle roundup reminded me of Tiananmen Square. That's CBS News. Family says to KSL, wake up, America. They're taking everything from us. They have the grazing rights since 1877. Militia members arrive. We're not afraid to shoot. That's the Washington Times. I mean, this could really blow up big time. Senator Sessions says there's a deliberate plan for the president to collapse law enforcement systems. I was playing part of Senator Sessions' powerful speech. We're going to go back to that right now, and then we have a guest who's coming up.
You hear that, colleagues? 94% of the people that were removed were either people captured at the border or had committed a serious crime. And most of the rest were repeat violators or fugitives that had been out on arrested on a fugitive warrant. So 99.9% of the 12 million illegal immigrants and visa overstays without known crimes on their record, including those fleeing from authorities, did not face removal last year. Former ICE Director John Sandwich said recently, if you are a run-of-the-mill immigrant here illegally, your odds of getting deported are close to zero. It's just not going to happen. Now, that's the truth. I was a federal prosecutor. I know how the system works. I've worked with ICE officers and Border Patrol officers and prosecuted their cases. This is what the reality is. If an individual has false documents, which is a felony for American citizens, that doesn't count as deportable crime. It's only a drug dealing or a crime of violence or some robbery that under the policies that we're carrying out. So it just goes to show that our law enforcement system is in a state of collapse. It's a deliberate plan by the President of the United States, and it's wrong. And people need to be aware of it and need to stand up to it, and I think the American people are beginning to do so.
What have I been saying, like a broken record, the last few years? Because I've studied tyranny historically. I have studied how these systems operate. Tyrants test you and see what they can get away with, and bureaucracies do as well. Just like kids, you know, bad kid or an abuser. It's the same MO. And if they can get away with anything, they will do it. And there's no country in the world that has totally open borders. We basically have wide open borders now. You have to commit an aggravated felony to be deported out of this country now. An aggravated felony. If a citizen gets caught filling out a gun form wrong and doesn't dot an I, they charge you with a felony, literally. And if you criticize all this, you're called a racist. If you don't like the attorney general who's in control of all this, allowing this to happen, you're a racist. If you don't like Obamacare, you're a racist. Don't want to turn your guns in, you're a racist. Don't want to pay for all the illegals, you're a racist. The globalists are just bringing in the foreign groups to vote to take our guns. They're giving them driver's license, everything. But here's the attorney general. He says it's all because we're racist. Here it is.
Pleased to note that the last 5 years have been defined by significant strides and by lasting reforms, even in the face of unprecedented, unwarranted, ugly, and divisive adversity. And if you don't believe that,
no, it's lawlessness.
You look at the way, and forget about me. Forget about me. You look at the way the Attorney General of the United States was treated yesterday by a House committee. Had nothing to do with me. Forget that. What Attorney General has ever had to deal with that kind of treatment?
I don't know. John M. Mitchell went to prison in 77.
What president has ever had to deal with that kind of treatment?
Presidents have had to step down repeatedly. I mean, she thinks you're dumb. The globalists have controlled the mainstream media for a long time, but now they're expanding, making the weaponization even more vicious and deceptive. All the major networks are state-run.
We are partnering this year with the NFL.
The NFL has become a political weapon against the Second Amendment and pushes Obamacare. MSNBC tells us that our children belong to the state.
We have to break through our kind of private idea that kids belong to their parents or kids belong to their families and recognize that kids belong to whole communities.
It is more important than ever to realize that we are not the alternative media. We are the true media. The establishment dinosaur press is dying.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
Join us at InfoWarsNews.com and PrisonPlanet.tv. Members can share their memberships with up to 11 people. By subscribing, you will literally be buying war bonds in the info war to expand our operation in the face of the tyrants. Join us at PrisonPlanet.tv. This is Alex Jones for InfoWarsLife.com. The latest in preparedness is now here. An electrically stabilized colloidal silver solution that can be added to both your home cabinet and preparedness pack alike. Concentrated to 30 parts per million in what has been dubbed the survival silver solution. The new InfoWars Life Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver is the answer for you and your family. And it's entirely free of toxic artificial additives that are loaded into many products. The InfoWars Life Silver Bullet Silver is so powerful that it is concentrated into a 2-ounce bottle and is not recommended for extended continual use. This is not a low-grade formula. We are working with one of the top laboratory manufacturers in the United States to bring you the best form of colloidal silver using electrical processes within a base of deionized water. For your preparedness storage or your home kitchen, purchase your bottle of InfoWarsLife.com Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver today and find other amazing supplements at InfoWarsLife.com.
A chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosate that is found in water supply worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products. Or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us today. We had Clive and Bundy on at the center of what the feds call an emergency in Nevada bordering Arizona, where for 140 plus years, 50 plus families there, mainly Mormons, ran cattle on the desert. Now all sorts of oil and stuff's been discovered there. For folks that don't understand property rights, you don't just have to own property. Back in the old days, open rangers, if somebody didn't want to, quote, own the land, they would just run cattle across it. But by doing that and exercising it and building the water tanks and things over the last 144 years, you then get open range use of it. You get the grazing rights, the water rights, the forage rights. You do it really being in there a year if nobody challenges your claim. Then it goes to state court. They're certified at the state. Feds tried to buy the land from them 10 years ago, again 4 years ago. They bought out or harassed most of the other ranchers into selling their rights. They got them to sell their rights, the state and the feds did. This is all on record. And the general public just might as well be speaking Martian telling people this. It's just like a lot of people own a ranch, but their granddaddy, some of our ranch, we've sold mineral rights to. I've seen documents where some of the mineral rights were sold 80-something years ago by my great-great-grandfather. You know, stuff like that. And then my dad goes through the records and shows that, oh, but they didn't have all this land that's ours. And so they've, you know, been doing stuff over here with mineral rights, leasing it to other companies, and really that's our money. And then you go get land lawyers to go in and dig into all of it because they know you're ignorant about it, okay? Believe me, I know about this stuff, not at a lawyer level, not at a land lawyer level, but more than even most lawyers who don't study land patent and all this. And the government is run by foreign corporations under a Bill Clinton executive order with UNESCO. I made a whole film about it in 1997, America Destroyed by Design. And all over the country, they're kicking people off the land. They're kicking people off the land that they own, that borders state and national parks, or that is encapsulated by it. They will block your access on a road to it and then basically take it by adverse possession. The feds are. Well, you can't do that if you already had a continuous use on a road that is advertised as a public right-of-way. Well, what the BLM will do is they'll just go in with bulldozers and put rocks in there and backhoes, and they will basically spike the road. And then when you try to drive around it, they'll write you a ticket saying, oh, that's no longer a road. Nowhere in common law. Go read English common law, U.S. common law. They've had this in Britain where people build a golf course across a common law walking path, whatever, and they have to open it back up. It's the same thing here, and Britain's actually been upholding that. Because the Brits walk so much, and the Scots and the Irish walk so much. Here, that's not the case, and people just don't know. And it's very, very frustrating to know about this and to see Clive and Bundy up there going, hey, I know my rights. And to go look at the state case, the governor has said now, no, he had grazing rights, he's had it before he was born, and what the feds are doing is illegal and is criminal and is wrong. That's CBS News. So it's just like when the state of Texas unanimously voted in the House to arrest TSA when they pat your genitals. And I've had prosecutors from San Francisco on saying, if we see someone touch somebody's genitals in a non-emergency, non-probable cause situation, we're going to arrest them for assault, sexual assault. And you notice that happened in a bunch of other counties. Suddenly the TSA isn't groping as many genitals. In fact, they've stopped at most airports because we pushed back, folks. We said no. So Forbes reported TSA threatens to cancel all flights out of Texas if groping bill passed. Then the lieutenant governor and others killed it. And Rick Perry killed it in the Senate, even though they had the votes, because they've threatened to put F-16s in the air. They didn't just threaten to cancel flights. They said, we will stop air traffic. We will embargo. We will blockade the state of Texas. That's how the Civil War started. I'm going to say that again. The state of Texas said, you're not going to touch people's genitals, and we're going to instruct the police in those airports not to do it. That's common sense, normal sanity, unanimous vote. The police don't want to do it. The TSA's responded by saying, we want to make our people armed now. Well, then you're going to have to get bonded officers. They want to pass a law to say, no, we can just give guns and whatever to our own goon squad. No training, no bond. We're talking a week-long course, and now, oh, that's a really great idea. That's a really great idea, is to arm the TSA. A bunch of mentally ill people who want to randomly sit around naked body radiation scanners all day getting cancer. I'm not saying all of them are bad. A lot of them have told me their listeners just want a job and some supervisors that like to grope people. And I know that's true. But this is the most dangerous group to give a uniform and a gun to because they go on these wild power trips. Statistically, the safest thing is a citizen. Now I'm going to shut up for now. I've always wanted to get him on because, you know, he just kept saying there'd be major earth changes. We're going to see massive earthquake increases. And you can look on his website, standale.com, and he has a USGS graph I saw today, if you scroll down, shows all the increased earthquakes. Now scroll down some more. There it is right there. See that white graph? Massive ring of fire increase, massive sinking and rising in different areas in the giant, massive supervolcano caldera out west. He talks a lot about that. And I hear him on Coast to Coast and go, you know, he sounds credible, but come on, you know, how does he know in the next few years this is all going to happen? Well, it's starting to happen. His background is in computer programming, marine architecture, advanced propulsion engineering, and biblical studies, earthquake forecasting. He says he's held an above top secret security clearance and worked undercover for the FBI as part of an exclusive black project. And he joins us.